Rolling.
How y'all doing? It's Miss Andre again. I just want to spend some time for those of you who are looking at employment outside of Work Crew with Broca. That's fantastic that you are at that point in working with us, but I want you to be fully prepared when it comes to your interview process. So yes, that employer is going to ask you a host of questions during the interview, but one very important question for most of you, you need to be able to answer the criminal background question. All employers have a right to know. You say, why? I say, hey, think about it like this. If you owned a company and you were a business owner, wouldn't you want to know what the people who work for you had on in their background? It's nothing bad about them knowing about your criminal background. But I want to teach you that there's a specific way to answer that question. And I've broke it down into five parts. The first is the opening, and I'll teach you a phrase that's going to open the door to that question and allow it to be some comfort when you are addressing that question. The second one is you're going to state your charge and the date that your charge occurred. Third part is you're going to express remorse. That is showing that you take responsibility for your actions. At the end of the day, you knew that you were breaking the law. So you need to show remorse for that. The fourth part is the cleanup. And then finally, it's the closing. As I said previously, most employers are going to ask you, and they want you to be honest. Because at the end of the day, if you don't share this information with them during the interview process, you don't bring it up, they don't bring it up, so you say, okay, Ms. Andre, they didn't ask me about my criminal background, so I didn't say anything. I say, big mistake. Because once you walk out of that room, all they're going to have is what is in Maryland Judicial Case Search and their own mindset. And some people's mindset includes biases, prejudices, and we know all kinds of things that prohibit them from wanting to take a chance and hiring individuals with criminal backgrounds. So I'm saying this to you, it is very, very important for you to understand that the employer has a right to know. At the end of the day, it's about keeping everybody in that company safe, right? You want to know what the charges are. It doesn't mean that they're not going to hire you, okay? The other flip side of this is people always ask, is it legal for people to not hire because you have a criminal background? Can they be sued? In some instances, absolutely yes. Because if that employer says, has a policy that is a blanket statement like, we don't hire anybody with a criminal background. If they say that, and that's in writing somewhere, absolutely, their legal action can be taken. There have been other instances where employers or companies have been sued because they have not hired individuals who fell under what is considered a protective class. So back in, I think it was 2012, Pepsi-Cola was sued. 250 African-American applicants applied for positions that they were qualified for at Pepsi, whether it was truck driver, warehouse, stock, whatever, and they were denied those positions based on their criminal background. What happened was they went to an attorney. The attorney said, oh, well, maybe there are more people out here like this. They galvanized all those people, 250 people. They confronted Pepsi and said, hey, pull those applications of all those individuals. All those individuals, with the exception of their criminal backgrounds, were qualified for those positions. So because they were all African American, which is a protected class according to the Equal Employment Opportunity Commission, they were able to file a lawsuit and say that the company was wrong for not hiring those people just based on their criminal background. And there were a host of different charges that those people had. So there is policy now has been instituted. I think that settlement was $2.3 million, if I'm not mistaken. And so those individuals got paid for that. Well, what happens to Pepsi is, moving forward, Pepsi can be audited or is going to be audited by the EEOC. And they look at all their applications to make sure that they don't fall back to doing that again, not hiring people just because they have a criminal background. So I'm saying all this to say is, this is a real thing. Like, you can be discriminated against and not even recognize it because you are paying attention to that. You just think, oh, they can do that. No, an employer does not have a right to make a blatant policy to say, we don't hire anybody with a criminal background. What the policy or the guidance from EEOC says that employers need to look at the length of time since the crime occurred. They need to look at the type of crime in relation to the job that you are applying for. And they need to look at, you know, what have you been doing since then? Right? All of those things to make a decision on whether or not they're going to take, right, a chance with hiring this individual. So they have to put all those things into account, make sure that that is noted, and then make the decision based on that. So when I talked to you about the first part of the question, I created this phrase that says, I'm glad you asked that question because I want you to be comfortable hiring me. That breaks the ice, right? When that employer asks you, oh, I see, you know, Mr. Johnson, you have a conviction on your background, and you started by saying, yeah, well, it was something that I did in my past. It's something, I was young and I made a mistake, and I'm not doing that anymore, and I've done things better in my life. Stop. That's not the best way to answer that question. What you don't want to do in an interview is you don't want to tell your story. We all have a story, and that story is great, and that story needs to be published in a novel, made into a movie, but it is not appropriate for a job interview. At the job interview, you need to be specific, concise, and direct. You do not need to spend a lot of time on your criminal background because that is not what you're there for. You are there to talk about your skill set as it relates to the position that you're applying for. And that's it. So I don't want you to get hung up on answering this question, but I do want you to practice answering it in a way that lifts you up and lets them know that, hey, you are, in spite of your past, the best person for this job. So it goes like this. Let me see. I'm going to do a little role play real quick. So I'm going to need my assistant to ask me the question, and then I'll show you all how it's done.
Excuse me, I noticed that there's some areas of concern in your background check here. I'm wondering if you could explain that to me, please.
Yes, I'm glad you asked that question because I want you to feel comfortable in hiring me. In 2005, I have a mail fraud and a wire fraud charge. It's not something that I'm proud of. It's not something that I'll ever do again. Since then, I have been working with young people, creating programming to help them obtain employment. I also do training and development. Do you have any other questions for me?
Not at this time. I'm wondering, is that all that you're doing now?
No, I do a host of other things. I'm active in my community. I also work with a mentoring program for young girls. And that sums it up.
I see. Yes, that's sufficient.
Do you think my criminal background would prohibit you from hiring me?
I think that's something we'll have to take into consideration as the interview process progresses.
Okay, I appreciate that. All right, thank you for that. So that's how you answer the question. You have to practice this. This is not something you can just say, oh, I got it, I'm gonna do it, and then you know, just say the first part. Okay, I'm glad you asked that question. I have a temporary charge, I caught a charge. No, you didn't catch a charge. We're not playing ball. You have a charge. So you want to state what that charge is, exactly how it is written in case search. Now, I will practice or work with you if you have a more violent charge, because this is the deal. More violent charges are scary to people, right? Like, let's be real. Attempted murder with a weapon, attempted armed robbery, weapon discharge. All those things, you really have to come real humble and explain and show your remorse for that action. So at the end of the day, the first part of this, I'll say to anybody, including myself, because I do, what I said was true. I have a conviction on my background. You have to own it. Okay? You don't have to be ashamed of it. You can let all of that go. Your shame, your, you know, negative thoughts that you have about what you did. At some point, you got to forgive yourself and move past that, right? I am not my past. That is something that I did. And I own that I did it, but I'm not carrying it like it's a heavy weight and oh, woe is me and nobody's going to hire me because I have a conviction. Okay? So when you can master answering this question, which comes with practice. When I first came home, I didn't answer this question appropriately. I told my story, and my story is really good. I should actually write it down one day and publish it. But it wasn't appropriate for the interview. So I'm saying all that to say, lesson that I learned. All the research, all my, you know, education and knowledge, I didn't know how to answer the question. Now, I formulated this model. It works. I've had employers compliment young men and women who I've taught this to and said, hey, that's great. I've never heard anybody answer that question like that. I had a participant one time answer this question when he was applying for housing. Got an apartment, and they ask you that question on application for apartments. You have to be able to answer it. And he said the same thing. I'm glad you asked that question because I want you to feel comfortable with me living in your community. He had a drug distribution charge. That's a big deal, right? So he was able to, right, explain all five of these steps. The remorse piece is huge. I've had employers personally tell me, oh, I didn't hire them because they didn't seem like they, you know, did anything wrong. They didn't show any type of remorse. And I'm not saying, you know, some people say, oh, I don't believe in saying I'm sorry. Okay, don't say you're sorry. But you need to acknowledge what you did was wrong. Because at the end of the day, you broke the law. It's the law. You broke it. I broke it. I gotta own it. You say it. You move on. You're clean up. Your cleanup is going to be different from my cleanup. What you don't want to say is you don't want to say things like, oh, I took an anger management class. Or I went to NA or AA, saying that you had some substance abuse problems. Those are anonymous programs. If you did that, great. That's your personal business. That goes with your story. What you want to say is, yes, I participated in a program with Roca Baltimore, teaching me, you know, work skills, work readiness skills. Right? Leadership skills, things like that. But you don't want to, again, digress or talk about, you know, your history, if you had drug abuse or if you sold drugs. None of that's appropriate for the interview. The other part of this is when I got to the end of my question, I responded and I said, do you have any other questions for me? There are some employers out here who don't follow appropriate HR practices. I'll just say it that way. So they may ask questions that are inappropriate, and you don't know. So I'm here to tell you, nobody has the right to ask you, well, what kind of drugs did you sell? Well, where did you sell your drugs? Well, where were you in prison at? It's not appropriate for the interview. So I'm telling you, you need to redirect. I'd be more than willing to answer more questions once I'm hired for the position. You can say, how is that relevant to the position I'm applying for? How is that going to be helpful in you hiring me? I'm curious. You don't have to be threatening. You don't have to be abrasive. You don't have to end the interview. You own that part of the interview. People do not have a right to treat or ask you questions, again, that aren't relevant, that are not appropriate. Those types of questions are based on that person's individual biases. So it's not appropriate. What type of drugs you sold, where you were, was anyone else involved? You have already been convicted and tried and served your time. And you can say that. I've already served my time. That is something that is in my past. I don't desire to go back and talk about the details. Again, how does that relate to the position I'm applying for? They're not going to put you out. They may be a little embarrassed because you called them on something that wasn't appropriate. On the other hand, if they end the interview and it's not good, maybe that wasn't the place for you to work because you want to be comfortable wherever you work, right? You don't want people to know what your background is. That's nobody's business. So again, practice makes perfect, right? They ask you the question. I see you have a conviction on your background. Come straight with it. I'm glad you asked that question because I want you to feel comfortable hiring me. Your stance, your body language is going to mean everything when you answer this question. If you're looking down, if you're fidgeting, if you're, you know, not sure, not a good look. Own This question, this is your question. It's your background. Nobody can take it from you. We can't hide it. You can't do anything with it because it's there. Unless you had something as a minor and it's sealed or it was expunged, right? But if it's there and it can be found, that employer has a right to know. So make sure that you practice the opening, stating your charges, showing the remorse, giving the cleanup. What are you doing now? What are you doing since you've been released from prison? What have you been doing to improve, to help your community, to help your family, to help your children, and for those of you who have children? And then the closing. Don't forget your closing. And if you're in the interview, this is the last piece, and you get through the whole interview, and they don't ask you about your criminal background. And you're like, whew, Ms. Andrea, you asked me, I'm going to go ahead. I say, no. Say to them, just one more thing. Because you have a right to know, I have something else I need to share with you. And that is, I have a conviction on my background. And I want you to know about it because I want you to feel comfortable hiring me. You gotta be honest. If you can't be honest here, how are you gonna be honest about other stuff when you get on the job? Employers will take a chance if you do what's right up front, not after the fact. So hopefully this brings some enlightenment to you. You will practice. I have handouts with this written down. I will make sure that all of the youth workers have it. All the guys on the crew, I'm sure, are going to get an opportunity to watch this. I wish you nothing but the best of success as you move forward and looking for a real job. All right? All right. Have a good day, y'all.